Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's very quickly review enolates of ketones and then see some other types of enolates. On the top of the screen to the left is a ketone. Ketones can be deprotonated with bases to make an enolate. The base will vary. LDA is a typical stronger base for this reaction, but under the right conditions, alkoxide bases or sodium hydroxide can also form the enolate in low concentrations. This is not new, and we've seen these ideas in other videos from other playlists. So, why can ketones make enolates? Well, it's because of the carbonyl. The carbonyl stabilizes the negative charge of the enolate through resonance delocalization. Great, once we have this enolate, we can do all kinds of things with it. We can do SN2 alkylations, we can do aldol reactions and aldol condensations. Enolates are awesome. Well, if a carbonyl can stabilize an anion, then other carbonyl functional groups beyond the ketone should also be able to make enolates. They can. On the bottom left is an ester. If we react an ester with LDA, we can make an ester enolate. Amides react with LDA by being deprotonated at the alpha carbon to make an amide enolate. Even nitriles, which certainly are not a carbonyl functional group, can be deprotonated with LDA. The resulting anion is not properly an enolate, but almost everyone calls these anions nitrile enolates, like enolates of carbonyl compounds, nitrile enolates are stabilized by resonance. In general, all these enolates require strong bases like LDA to form. We'll talk about one exception later in this playlist. Once the enolates are formed, they can do pretty much anything that ketone enolates can do. SN2 alkylations? Sure. Aldol reaction? No problem. So that's a quick introduction to enolates of carbonyl compounds beyond ketones. We'll walk through each functional group to give specifics for the rest of the playlist.